Hi all, I'm Vladimir, you're watching the BeamerDog channel. Today I'll show you how you can activate Apple CarPlay on your BMW. That will be like the easiest and the quickest way possible ever. Stay tuned. In this video I'll show you three main steps about activation of the CarPlay. The first one, how to make sure your head unit in your BMW can at all support the CarPlay. The second one is the process of the activation, how that should be done. And the third one, but it's not the least important, is the troubleshooting. What you should do if you have already activated CarPlay but you cannot connect to your phone. Step one, making sure your BMW at all supports the CarPlay. At first, your head unit have to support that. If your BMW is 2015 or newer, then it should, it can support the CarPlay. The most easiest way to make it sure, go to navigation settings, into the map, open the map, and there you have to check the navigation map version. For that, press options and go to navigation settings. Over there, go to the most lower position version, open that, and over here you can see version information, open that. If over there you can see, for example, Europe Evo or America Evo or Middle East Evo, Asia Evo, whatever, you can see that. If it's written Evo there, it's really good sign. It means you have NBT Evo and that should support CarPlay. To be honest, there are different NBT Evo versions, ID 4, 5 and 6, where CarPlay is supported. If you're not sure what version do you actually have, just make a picture of your navigation map version and send it to me. I'll tell you if your head unit does support CarPlay or not. One more important thing to know about the CarPlay, there are two options. Will it be full screen, as you can see over here, or it will be only half screen. What do I mean by half screen? Basically, the right side of the screen is not used by CarPlay and it's used with whatever other information. Step 2, activation of the CarPlay. For that, you will need Ethernet cable for BMW, looks like that one over here. You can purchase it from eBay, Amazon or whatever other platform. And Windows-based laptop. Basically, that's all you need. All the rest of the software I'll provide for you. How to set everything up that it will work. Step number one, start your car. Basically, after starting your car, wait for at least 30 seconds. That will make sure that all the ECUs inside the car will boot up and will be ready for connection. Then, take the OBD cable and connect it to the car. The other part of the Ethernet cable goes to your Windows-based laptop. If you don't have Ethernet port over there, you can use adapter, like Ethernet to Type-C or Ethernet to Type-A, whatever you have. That will also work. The next step in activation process after you have connected your car with your laptop using Ethernet cable is running special software. It's called Feature Installer. You'll receive that program from me. Basically, just make sure you will run that program after you have connected your car to the laptop. The feature installer will ask special code from you. That code, you will receive that from me. I will generate that code for you based on your VIN code of your BMW. Basically, VIN code is 17 digit, your identification number of your vehicle. In order for feature installer to work, your laptop has to be connected to the internet. Basically, make sure you have connected laptop to internet. You can use your home Wi-Fi, or you can make a hotspot from your phone, or using whatever other public internet, it's also okay. Next step, insert the code to the program. The code will look like that. It will be a 10-digit code. Just copy that and paste into that program. If you have internet connection, you should have. The feature installer will analyze your code you have received from me and will say it's good to go. Press continue. When you have pressed continue, press the button find vehicle. As you can see, the program is searching for the vehicle. It has determined the VIN code of my car and press then identify. And the program will make all the magic. Basically, it will identify based on that code, what options have you ordered? If you needed only CarPlay, CarPlay with full screen, video in motion, navigation map update, whatever you asked will be included in your code. As you can see, the process is fully automated, so basically you don't have to do anything. Just make sure you have connection to the internet. Also, it will not hurt if you have disabled your firewalls and different antivirus softwares. Sometimes you can work with them, sometimes they might hamper your work. It depends what type of antivirus software you are using. If you have problems connecting to the car, then the firewall or the antivirus is the problem. As you can see, the program has analyzed all your vehicle. It says what type of head unit you have, what level of software there is, and so on. And basically, you are ready to start. So let's press the start button and see what will happen. Just pressing the start. It is three-phase process. Take a look at the head unit. It has turned blue. It's totally okay. That's the part of the process. Basically, at the moment, you can see that the flashing of the head unit is happening and all the features you have chosen are being installed to the head unit. At that time, I am making demo based on my BMW G30 and I'm installing to myself CarPlay, CarPlay full screen, video in motion and navigation data update. As you can see, the process is running. It's step 2 out of 3. The head unit might restart several times. It's totally okay. Just make sure you have still the internet connection. That's all you need. The method of the activation of the CarPlay I'm using right now, it's like the really straightforward. It's way more easier compared to the method I have shown in my previous video. You don't have to make any tunnel between two laptops, assigning the time and so on. Basically, whenever you have purchased the code from me, you can do that procedure, whatever time it's suitable for you. And the phase 2 has ended. It's going to go to phase 3. And the head unit has restarted again. And you can see the head unit is already booted up and restarting again. The screen is black. Just make sure. Wait a bit and it will boot up again. Now you can see it's written success. That's perfect. Basically, the head unit has booted up and it should work all fine. And that's it. Now you have CarPlay, you can start using it. You saw how straightforward and easy it was. It's super cheap, super easy, and super reliable. In addition to that method, the big plus of that method, basically, based on that same code, you can activate the CarPlay at the time it's convenient for you. You don't have to agree time with me or with someone else. Also, if you're going to visit BMW dealership and you have to make your downgrade your head unit back to not have a CarPlay, if you have warranty or whatever other issues, with the same code, using the same program, you can downgrade. Basically, next time, if you'll connect the same program to a BMW, it will ask, do you want to downgrade it back or what do you want to do? Basically, just press yes and then you revert all the back. And after the software update or whatever dealer BMW dealer does to a BMW, basically using the same code, you can activate CarPlay again by yourself. You don't need any other assistance. We have finished with activation of CarPlay. You can close your laptop and now I'll show you how you can pair your phone with your BMW. First, go to connected drive, over there, manage mobile devices. Press there. If you have any phones there, just forget all the phones. That's a really essential step. Also, forget all the cars from your phone. That's also an essential step. Press connect new device and you should see Apple CarPlay. Press over there. Now press confirm and you should see the 5-digit code after the BMW. It means that your car now is active and sending the code to your phone. Now open your Bluetooth settings, open there. Make sure your Wi-Fi is on and your phone is not connected via Wi-Fi to any other Wi-Fi networks. Now your car should appear under the Bluetooth settings. It's searching for that. If you cannot see any connections, just turn your Bluetooth off and then turn Bluetooth on again. Now you can see your BMW has appeared there, press there. And the phone will establish connection with the car. Yes, press pair and on the car press OK. On the phone also press allow. The sequence does not matter. you can press on the phone first and then on the car and vice versa. If your phone shows something, press yes, use CarPlay. And the connection is being established. So now you have CarPlay. Part 3, troubleshooting. Sometimes people experience problems while connecting their phone to the car via the CarPlay. What are the most common issues you have to be aware about? First, you have to understand the principle how the CarPlay works. The first, your phone is establishing connection with the car via the Bluetooth, and then it is switching to the Wi-Fi. That's why having Wi-Fi antenna in your car is essential for CarPlay either to work properly or connect at all. There are two types of Wi-Fi antennas that can be installed in BMWs. Sometimes the antenna is pre-installed to your car. You can determine that from your VIN code of the vehicle. You should have those SA options in your VIN code. If you have those, that's good. It means you have pre-installed Wi-Fi antenna. If you don't have Wi-Fi antenna in your car, you can add it by yourself. Basically, you have to just take out your head unit and then install the antenna. There are two types of antennas. The factory antenna looks like that, and the Chinese antenna looks like that. Both of them work perfectly fine, no problems with those. You can also buy those on Amazon or eBay. On the majority of the newer BMWs, G series, those Wi-Fi antennas are pre-installed. On the E series, it is not as common as on G series, but that antenna can be easily added, plug and play, no extra coding needed. It's like really easy. You can do it by yourself without any problem. Next, most typical issue about not being able to connect the CarPlay to a car is not having Siri active. If you cannot see CarPlay in your car after the activation process, have a look at the screen. Let's pretend you're going to the connected drive, manage mobile devices, connect new device, and you cannot see that option over there. It means you have to restart your head unit. In order to restart your head unit, you have to press your volume button and hold that for 10 to 15 seconds. Just keep holding until the head unit will reboot. Just wait for that. After the reboot, your CarPlay should appear. Sometimes the longer press is needed, but it works always. After the head unit has been rebooted, go to connected drive, manage mobile devices, and now you should see Apple CarPlay. And thank you for watching the video about the activation of the CarPlay. I really hope that you found this video useful for you. If you need any assistance, contact me and I'll help you out.